powerful nearby. Where is your master?
The dark side has clouded your mind. You killed my master years ago.
Then now you will share his fate. A son. Your hatred has become your strength. At last, the dark side is your ally. Rise, my apprentice.
What is your will, my master?
Your training is nearly complete. It is time to face your first true test.
Your spies have located Jedi?
Yes, Master Ram Kota. He's attacking a critical Imperial shipyard. Destroy him and bring me his lightsaber.
I shall do it at once, master.
The Emperor cannot discover you. Leave no witnesses. Kill everyone aboard, Imperials and Kota's men alike.
As you wish, my master.
Proceed to catch me by surprise. I hadn't fought that training program in years. I thought you'd erased it.
I hoped that using an older training module would catch you off guard and allow me to finally kill you. I'm sorry I failed to attack.
I'm sure you'll keep trying. Yeah, but do me a favor. Don't ambush me.
Yes, my name is Prince. Yes, your new pilot has finally arrived.
After seeing your records. Captain Jiro Clips, born on Carlac, where she became the youngest student ever accepted into the Imperial Academy. Decorated combat pilot with over 100 combat missions, and commanding officer during the bombing of Paris. Handpicked by Lord Vader to lead his Black Fire Squadron, but later reassigned to a top secret mission. Is there a psychological profile in me?
Actually, yes. Restricted. Oh, Master, I can tell you she's going to be impossible to reprogram.
Do you know where
you're going? Yes, my orders are clear, and keep your ship running and fly wherever your missions require. Did Vader tell you that he killed our last pilot? No. But I can only assume that he gave Lord Vader good reasons to do so. I will not.
I'm sick of training new pilots. What have you done with my ship?
Mm-hmm. I've taken the liberty of upgrading the Rogue Shadow sensor array. Now you'll be able to fly any sensor ships within the entire system. You are one of Vader's spies.
You don't need to know anything about my missions except where I'm going. I need to jump to Nar Shaddaa. Can you handle that?
Of course.
Roxy, give me the target.
According to Imperial records, Master Ram Kota was a respected general in the Clone Wars.
You're hunting Jedi.
I bring Darth Vader's enemies to justice. Now so do you.
Master Kota was a military genius, but felt that clone soldiers were unfit for battle. Instead, he relied on his own militia.
So there were no clones in his squad when Order 66 was issued?
And after Order 66, he vanished. Official Imperial records actually claim he's dead.
Why come out of hiding and attack the Empire now?
He wants to be found.
Then we're walking into a trap. How many pilots have you lost before me?
7.
Excellent. Coordinates for Nar Shaddaa are locked. Prepare for light speed.
Lock down the command center and get that hologram projector up and running.
Yes, sir.
Tell all squads to fan out and funnel any opposition towards us. Explosive charges on levels 2, 5, and 12, just like we planned.
General Kota.
He's here.
I've finally drawn you out of hiding. Lower the containment field on Hangar 12 and tell the men to get into position.
Yes, General.
Eclipse to Starkiller. I'll be moving the Rogue Shadow out of firing range while you attend to your mission. The onboard scanners should be able to track your movements, and I will provide whatever intelligence support I can via your comlink. Captain Eclipse, out.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to part 2 of one of my favorite Star Wars video games, and I would argue a story calling one of the best Star Wars characters, Starkiller. And once again, we are now being introduced to the Force Unleashed. right now, as you can see, I'm taking my time to try to get some points built up just by destroying shit, which I'm pretty sure just by using your force powers and your lightsaber and breaking stuff like Limp Bizkit, that's kind of how you level up there. Not gonna lie. Even though I've been playing this game for 10 years, I 100% do not understand how all the systems work and stuff. But you're gonna get to watch me blast through some stormtroopers and some rebels, and it's gonna be fun, because we all love wanton destruction and violence. I'm gonna try to get through these first two or three missions without really, you know, spending anything, just using the, you know, default weakest level of skills, not spending any force points like you see I just got with that holocron. I'm gonna be going through trying to get all the objectives for each of the maps, which, as you can see here, these are the objectives that, you know, you'll get, like getting a certain amount of force points, getting a certain amount of holocrons, all that kind of good stuff. The game has an upgrade system. Like you can see, you can upgrade your force powers, your force combos, and your force talents, which all do different things to help augment and strengthen our lovely, lovely Sith Lord. And we also are able to unlock different colored lightsabers. Like right now, I just unlocked the yellow lightsaber. And you can also unlock different costumes throughout the game. And some of which you cannot unlock throughout the game, you have to use through cheat codes, which I might show you once we get through the first run of the story. I might not. We'll have to see what we end up doing. I don't know how I couldn't figure this out, but first playthrough, I couldn't figure out to use both sticks to make the force go faster, because I guess that's how force joysticks work. I don't know. Let's just break shit. The game starts you off with a tutorial, which I'm not going to quite show you guys later. I'm not going to show you guys yet, I'll show you guys that later. But, there we have yet another holocron recovered. And you're going to be ambushed by even more of militia troopers. And I think this is where we get introduced to the militia saboteur, a melee-focused opponent, who brings some wrinkles to your typical lightsaber combat. Who I just stabbed through the heart. Like a fuckboy, because you know I'm heartless. go around shredding those stormtroopers like cheese, as is the name of the game. Out here I like to go ahead and, as we get out into this little catwalk open section, we're going to use the Force and we're going to create ourselves a little clothesline to hang up some of these TIE fighters, even though I've already completed the objective of, I believe it's you need to destroy 5 TIEs here on the TIE Fighter Factory in order to get your bonus objective for the map. You're going to get attacked by more malicious saboteurs, and you have lots of explosives that you can just chuck into their face and melt them and make them completely unrecognizable. And not only are we going to take advantage of these heavy explosives and of these barrels, we're also going to make use of our Force Grip and Force Throwing powers and send these kids flying all the way down to the bottom of whatever empty abyss this ship happens to be. And we're also going to find some holocrons along the way. As you can see, there's one right there that's Force Talent Spear, which will allow us to upgrade our Force Talents. What would you guess? Take these stormtroopers around, throw them around like a toddler playing with some fucking Lincoln Logs. Because your toddler didn't want Lincoln Logs, he wanted the cool toys. Whatever those toys were, it's probably different for you than it was for me. I was into Power Rangers, I respected my toys, I did not throw them around like Lincoln Logs. Sound off in the comments if you were a kid who liked to destroy his toys. I will fully admit, when I was a child, I somehow did not know that you were supposed to go forward past that one little enclave where the holocron is, and I also somehow could not make it past the not rapid fire, like TIE fighters. It took me a couple of tries to figure out how to get past that catwalk, to figure out like where to go. I don't know how. How was I that stupid? Like truly. Push these doors apart, as we should, as that's the only force power we have right now, and we have ample ammunition to throw at this all-terrain construction transport. I think this is one of only, like, 2 in the game. I don't know why this guy is here, because he has a great design, But he's absolutely fucking useless. We just crumple him into a ball like a love letter that we didn't send to that girl that we happen to have a crush on in our middle school science class. You know how it goes. And in this room, we got a bunch more holocrons that we're gonna go ahead and get. We got a bunch more militia that we're gonna kill. And we've got a bunch more, jumping around. I really wish we got to see more of those AT-CTs, because I think they're a really cool design. As well, I think if they were equipped with something more offensive, like maybe those tractor beams were able to be used as, like, lasers, like, I feel like that would be really cool. Or if it had, like, a little rotating Gatling thing. Also, another thing, why does the AT-KT exist? Why? We'll get to that when we get to Kashyyyk, but I'm prepping you guys for advance. Why does the ATKT exist? Because it's like, it's just a worse version that doesn't need to exist of Ozzik Stern's custom-made ATST. Which, again, when we get to Kashyyyk, we'll get there. But for now that we've found all the holocrons in the room, we're just gonna clear this place out of the last of the Rebels and the clones, and we're going to start moving on to the next section of the game, which I massively, massively fuck up, and you will feel very free to laugh as hard and as loud as you can in my face. So I didn't mention this before, but in the previous section, back when we were out on the catwalk, when we came in from the catwalk, a new enemy type was introduced, the Militia Elite Soldiers. These guys carry Gatling guns, and I thought these guys were going to be a lot more imposing, but they're not. They're just a little bit more heavily armored, and they're able to, like, kind of chip away at your health. But other than that, we've got a Sith Holocron over there that we're going to use in a little bit, and then you guys are going to see me struggle. So we got to get that holocron up there by putting in these TIE fighter wings. So we got to place them in between those slots, which, hold on, let me kill that guy, which is not very easy to do. So I usually just set it on top of the slots, but that also proves to be difficult, as you can see, because although you're given the tools to do what you need to do, they're not very effective. They're not very effective. It's kind of hard to, you know, make use of what is given to you, because the physics in the game is kind of janky, and it's kind of hard to figure out which, like, steps you need to use to put the TIE fighter wings where they go, as well as to get them to balance properly on the piece. There we get our 1,000 force points, and then eventually I just get pissed off and start throwing the wings everywhere and using the force. Also, having very limited force grip, that's another area where it does not help in the situation. I struggled at this for literally like 45 minutes. This was like an hour and a half of recording. All just to do this one mission, all because of this one little section. Feel free to laugh at my misery. And do it loud. Please. I am a dumb. Thank you. finally, we get the TIE wing in place, and then we're able to jump across all these wings. Don't go on that last one, it'll just slide you down. You don't need to use the dashing blast, just use your regular force dash. Time your jump, leave a little bit of space, and then boom. That's how you get now your power crystal, which is a way you can augment your lightsaber to be able to do extra different kinds of damage, modify yet another aspect of how you go about fighting your enemies. So not only is there that Sith holocron that allows you to health drain all the enemies around you, there we've also found our Jedi holocron for 10,000 force points, which I believe you need 250,000 to get the bonus for. But other than that, we're going to go through this TIE construction area, we're going to kill these militiamen, and we're going to find ourselves some holocrons. And here we found all the enemy types by this point in the game. It's just the soldiers, the saboteurs, and the elite, as well as the stormtroopers and the occasional, stormtrooper officer. We're not gonna get anything more varied or complicated than that. They're all easy. They're all cannon fodder. I just gave that guy concussive brain damage, and I really don't feel that bad about it. As well, sometimes what's fun is to try and pull these little cockpits off the factory line, and you can use those as weapons to throw at people. Or you can use the little construction lasers, and you can use those to incinerate people. Lots of ways they give you to have absolute destructive mayhem chaos fun. They're gonna throw a bunch of these melee guys at you because you want to be using your force powers a little bit more. You're gonna come in here and get your holocron for 10,000 force points, which is fun and dandy, and you're also going to throw these people into these tractor beams, or whatever they are, because, yes, they damage you, but they damage your opponents way, way more. Check and make sure that there isn't one over here. But yeah, we're getting towards the last section on the map before we have to go up and face the big boss. Finish clearing out the baddies, turn over to the right, there's going to be that last holocron, and then you can see we've got 5 out of 5 TIE fighters, we've got the right amount of force points, and we've got all holocrons. Now, it's time to go face General Kota.
This is it. Kota is just above you now.
I'm ready.
Months of attacking Imperial targets and Vader sends a boy to fight me?
Doing this fight is far more tedious when you don't have Force Repulse and Force Lightning. and lightsaber throw. You can't just spam these abilities to get his health down in like 17 seconds. You gotta wait for him to do his jumping attacks, avoid his shockwaves, which you can't really do. And then you can knock him over like he's papier-mâché, you can stab him, which is all well and good. He will take lots and lots of damage. It's just about being patient, waiting for your openings, and then knocking the old man on his ass. Like we're a rowdy, rowdy teenager running through an old suburban neighborhood. Cause fuck you, Grandpa, I won't do what you told me.
You're stronger than I thought, but I can't let you live, boy. I'll be sure to send your ashes back to Vader. You have so much to learn about the Force.
He's gonna throw these pieces of debris at you, which is always a good idea to use this little piece of roofing after he's pulled the entire, I guess, command center down. Hide behind that and then jump up at him, knock him over with force push, and then just continue going to work on him. It's a very quick and easy thing to do once you have more force powers, but when you just have your lightsaber, force push and force grab, it's gonna take a little bit. There's not a whole lot that you can do, but luckily it's really not that hard to figure out. You're gonna stab him in the chest, and here goes your final minigame. You get to throw him against the wall, bash him against the floor, throw a tile at him, and then you're just gonna smash him against the glass. Like that. Boom! And then like this. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next part.
Vader thinks he's turned you, but I can sense your future. And Vader won't always be your master. I sense only me. Die! Die!
Master Kota is dead?
Yes.
His lightsaber. My spies have located another Jedi. Kazdan Paratus is far more powerful than you. I do not expect you to survive, but if you destroy him, you'll be one step closer to your destiny.
The Emperor.
Yes. Only together can we defeat him.
I will not fail you, my master.
Amazing. It looks just like the Jedi Temple on Coruscant.
Proxy, are you picking up any communications?
Too many to decipher. I can hear thousands of droids all calling out to each other. This is where all droids go to die.
Set us down as close to that thing as you can.
I'll do my best. There are not many clearings. You'll need to approach the temple on foot.
Returning to low orbit. Scanners show you'll need to make it through that large hyperdrive core in front of you. Once on the other side, you should be able to reach the junk temple. Good luck.